A debate on the State of the Nation address is not an easy debate, not in the year of the elections. Members will say whatever they say. Members must engage with the debate.
He's the first to admit that the ANC's time has expired.
For whatever is left of my life, Your Excellency, that broken promise will be the knife in my heart.
Who do Honourable you think you are? You can just rise and talk. This is not your house.
Honourable Member.
It is personal attack. I think it's unwarranted.
On Sona Debate 2019, of course, it was not as dramatic or epic as during the time of our former president, Jacob Zuma, where people will be kicked out of parliament, people will be singing, protesting. There was nothing like that. And I've watched it about 2 times, searching for all the medical parts to summarize them for you. Unfortunately, none of the debaters or the members of the parliament that were talking challenged the president's views on health, but I had to make a summary because the previous video was a success, at least for my channel. If you're interested in checking it out, I'll link it in the description. I'll summarize the points I find interesting stated by the 3 major parties, namely the ANC, the EFF, and the DA. The ANC part, delivered by the chief whip of the ANC, he focused mainly on the expropriation of land without compensation, and he stated many points.
We are fast-tracking land reform by implementing our resolutions on the expropriation of land without compensation. Parliament is already in the process of crafting a constitutional amendment to amend Section 25 of the Constitution to make it explicit that our Constitution allows expropriation of land without compensation.
And of course, he dropped some roast on the DA.
The irony of a party which refers to itself as the Democratic Alliance repeatedly silencing vocal black women is indicative of their true nature, which is a white male-dominated party only concerned with protecting and entrenching white privilege. The DA fronts black faces to pursue the agenda of white privileged minority to the detriment of black majority. Their latest victim, Patricia Delay, who likened the DA to Animal Farm, where the white race is far more equal than the black race. In short, you are likened to a racist party. Another victim of DA racism is former City of Cape Town Chief Whip, Sean August, who said, open quotes, "My decision does not come lightly, considering the 2 years of struggle, discrimination, and double standards that I've been subjected to by the DA," close quotes, proving that the DA remains the epitome of white male privilege. The common denominator between the DA and the alliance partner, the EFF, is that they are both male-dominated. The EFF is that, in fact, since 2014, the EFF has gotten rid of 19 MPs and a countless number of councillors. Last week, true to their attention-seeking behavior, they claimed that the ANC copied their election manifesto. A manifesto which has actually been characterized as the work of crude opportunists, which is incoherent and unimplementable.
In this part, as the chief whip of the ANC was speaking, he reminded me of our former president, Jacob Zuma, when he did this. I miss you so much, Jacob Zuma. Also, the DA, during their time when they spoke, they raised very good points. But the highlights for me, at least, which I found most interesting, was when Musimba Imana fired back at the ANC by saying this.
Under the ANC, SONA now stands for the State of No Action.
And also, as usual, Musima Imana, weak chicken! He refused to answer questions as usual.
Honorable Maimane, are you prepared to take a question? No, he's not prepared.
Of course, the EFF, during their time when they spoke, they accused Mr. Cyril Ramaphosa of having copied their manifesto and presented it as the State of the Nation address.
President, a more significant part of the State of the Nation address delivered here on the 7th of February 2019 lacked originality and made very dangerous.
Honorable Malema, proposal. Please give me a minute.
Furthermore, the point that I found most interesting that was raised by the EFF was when it comes to ESCOM.
The president did not give a thorough diagnosis of the challenges that confront ESCOM, but has a remedy that will benefit his friends and family. Your diagnosis deals only with the financial aspect of the crisis, and you don't provide structural and strategic diagnosis of the asset. Your wrong diagnosis is extremely dangerous and not different from fake doctors who give wrong medication to patients and endangering their lives. Your approach to ESCOM is going to destroy the power utility, and as people who will be here and still active in the next 30 to 40 years, we are not going to allow you to destroy ESCOM for quick personal gains. What is more painful is that you have abandoned politics and you put profit and business in everything else you do. There is no ideological justification you can give on why you want to unbundle ESCOM, except the fact that you and your immediate stand to benefit, including your companies, because you are still an active a business person who just took leave to come and irritate us here. Let us deal with ESCOM problems honestly and openly, because an attempt to privatize it will never be accepted. And you must be rest assured, President, that if you are not going to give an assurance that you will re-look into this ESCOM matter, we'll waste no time, we'll go to the picket lines and defend this strategic asset of our people.
In the State of the Nation address, the President stated that they're planning to start replacing the hard copies of the textbooks in high schools and government schools with tablet-based textbooks, where they will give students tablets with textbooks inside them, like the soft copies, and students can use them. Julius Malema raised an interesting point in that.
Why are you not talking about giving fast and affordable data? Because you are going to give the kids tablets in schools, yet data is expensive. Those tablets are going to be useless. But it will not be for the first time, because you are known to have given people taps without water. So you will not be practicing this type of things for the first time.
I'm currently in the journey to 200 subscribers. You can help me reach that goal by subscribing to the channel and turning on the notification bell so you can be notified of all my future videos. And in closing, I would like to take this opportunity to encourage all South Africans, especially the young ones, to participate in the upcoming elections. And also, I'm not a political specialist or whatsoever. Views shared in this video are my personal interest and nothing more and nothing less. Thank you for watching. Goodbye. Have a good day.